Since Goku achieved Ultra Instinct, he has outright been stronger than Vegeta ever since DBS ended. Even if he can't tap into it, it's just facts that by the time DBS ended, they had to leave it on Goku being stronger than Vegeta. Now, in the latest chapter of Dragon Ball Super, Goku is about to confront the main villain of this arc, Moro. What's most interesting about this is that usually Goku and Vegeta would be together. Especially in Dragon Ball Super, Goku and Vegeta have often fought alongside each other against the main villain, just like they did against Frieza and Broly, but this is very different. Vegeta made it a point earlier on in this story that he was going his own way, not relying on Goku's techniques to get him out of situations. It's time he learnt things on his own, and it seems to be paying off for him. He finds a spaceship, heads straight towards planet Yajirat. A few chapters later, Vegeta seems to be completely oblivious to how powerful he's getting by learning off these people. He's able to convincingly wipe out Moro's soldiers without even trying. But even with all of this new power, Vegeta is still not satisfied. Before any of this even happened, Vegeta outright said he does not want to learn Ultra Instinct and he can find his own way to get stronger. So when Goku found Mirus and went to train in Ultra Instinct, you would think that would have made Goku a lot more powerful than Vegeta again. But that's not what happened. Goku's training with Mirus got cut short, and so he wasn't able to learn everything he could about unlocking Ultra Instinct. That's why he's the first one back on Earth to confront Moro, and Vegeta is still training. Some of the techniques that Vegeta is learning from the Yajirats is the ability to change your size, have clones of yourself, but most importantly, it's spirit control. Something about controlling every aspect of energy within your body. I have no doubt that Vegeta will learn everything he can off these Yajirats, instant transmission, size manipulation, but one thing I wasn't expecting was that overall, he would be much stronger. It almost feels like he's gotten his potential unlocked. One thing I am pretty sure about now is that this will be Vegeta's arc. We haven't seen the full extent of his progress, but from everything available right now, in the future of Dragon Ball Super, Vegeta will get his moment. But it's not gonna come easy. The Yajirats tell him that when Goku was there, it took him 150 days to learn only the basics of instant transmission. Obviously, Vegeta doesn't have that kind of time, but he is making the most of it. It doesn't look like he will get a new transformation or anything like that, but instead, he will be getting new techniques and a much better understanding of how to control his energy. Specifically, to narrow it down, Vegeta is working on something purely to counter Moro's magic. Whatever that is, he does have the right idea, and this is where Goku's getting caught lacking a little bit. When you're coming up against a guy who can suck the life out of you before a punch can be thrown, what really is the point of Ultra Instinct against something like that? Unless Ultra Instinct can dodge planets being absorbed, I think Goku's gonna be in for a really tough time, especially when he has to fight Moro first. And that's the main point. In Dragon Ball, it's always whoever fights first loses. With the main villain of an arc, whoever steps up to them initially often gets beaten down. And usually, that is Vegeta. It happens so many times, even in early DBS. But this could be a one-off Android 19 situation where Goku goes in first and then Vegeta has to clean up, just on a much larger scale. It has been slightly foreshadowed earlier in the recent chapters when Whis told Beerus about Moro and what he was doing to the planets of Universe 7, and Beerus just ignored it. Once this is all said and done, and if Vegeta gets his first legit W of Super, he could be headed down a path leading him with the choice of being the next God of Destruction. Because Moro should have been dealt with by Beerus a long time ago, without doubt. That is Beerus' job. That's all he really has to do in Universe 7, make sure guys like Moro don't exist. And to have someone like Vegeta fill in and do it for him, it's not going to make Beerus look good. But that is way down the line. There's a lot of work to be done. I'm more so projecting how I want the story to go than anything else, but let me know what you think. This way, everything would fall together in place pretty perfectly. Anyway, I want to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next Dragon Ball video.